Oh, there you are, YouTube. Today, I gotta talk about WandaVision Episode 5. It was amazing. Spoilers. Gotta let everybody know that there are spoilers. So if you've not seen it, don't watch, because I'm jumping ahead to the end, the stuff everybody wants to talk about, that cameo. I heard there was going to be a cameo and that it was going to be a big deal. And I know some people who stayed up till midnight last night to watch this episode, and I was seeing their reactions online. I didn't get any spoilers, but I was just seeing some reactions, and people went crazy. They, like, were so hyped, so excited, like, so amazed, shook, all of this stuff. And I'm like, what could it be? I know there's a cameo, that's all I know. And I'm thinking, you know, multiverse, Doctor Strange, that's not an amazing cameo to me, because Vision and Wanda, they are in the movies, so that would just be somebody from the movies coming into the show. So I don't care if it was Iron Man, I don't care. Anybody from the show, I didn't care. Or sorry, from the movies, from the MCU, I didn't care. And I was thinking, you know, I guess it could be, you know, Aaron Taylor Johnson comes back, you know, maybe Wanda, like, wants to see her brother, so she brings him back, and I'm like, but that's not exciting. And the people that I'm seeing react online to what they just saw are so excited. And I'm like, I mean, maybe that's it, but that doesn't get me hyped over this. But it would be cool, you know, I'd be like, oh wow, that's awesome. But it wouldn't give me a sense of excitement that would match what I was seeing online. So I was like, I know who it's gonna be. It's gonna be Magneto, played by Ian McKellen. So I'm talking about Fox X-Men universe hopping over to the MCU, and we're gonna see Ian McKellen, like, at her front door or something like that. WandaVision has her father show up, and it's Ian McKellen. And that's, and, you know, now I was also thinking, you know, well, I guess it could be Michael Fassbender too, which would be cool. But if they're going to, like, blow the roof off the house, it has to be Ian McKellen. And I'm watching the episode, and it's a good episode too. I mean, we're getting a lot of information, plus it has all these great 80s, 90s television show references, like Growing Pains. I think maybe some Family Ties, looked like there was some Full House, maybe even some Family Matters, maybe a little Step by Step, all those great shows from the 80s and 90s, right? So we're seeing all that, I'm loving it, I'm eating it up, it's so good. And then at the very end, we hear like a door knock, right? And I'm like, this is it. This is the moment everybody was talking about. This is where the cameo comes in. We open the door, and what we get is a point of view, sort of like an over-the-shoulder shot of the person that's at the door, right? And what do we see? It's a blurry vision because focus is on Wanda, who just opened the door. So the vision, we're seeing a blurry image, right? What color's the hair? The hair is gray. I start leaping, not leaping, I wasn't leaping yet. I start rising out of my seat thinking, oh shoot, they did it. Ian McKellen is showing up. This is it. Magneto, her dad, is right there on screen. And then there was a rack focus, right? Focus shift away from Wanda to the hair, the gray hair. And I could tell that was not an old man's cut. That was not an old man's cut. And I was like, darn it, that's Quicksilver. They got Aaron Taylor Johnson back. So then I was kind of bummed. I was like, you know, still cool, but it wasn't what I wanted. I wanted Magneto, and they gave me Aaron Taylor Johnson as Quicksilver. So I was like, you know, cool, good episode. But this was all running through my head in this, you know, seconds, right? But it wasn't what I wanted. But, you know, kudos for a good episode. This was solid. You know, I dig it. I still love this show. But then we get the point of view of Wanda, and it's Quicksilver, but it's not Aaron Taylor Johnson. It's Evan Peters. I'm talking about Quicksilver from Days of Future Past. When I saw Days of Future Past, when I saw Evan Peters do that time in a bottle, fast run in slow motion, that was, I still to this day think it's one of the greatest scenes I've seen in cinema history. Like I put that up there, pantheon, upper echelon of the greatest scenes of all time. I know it's a commercial film, I know it's mainstream, but I think it's one of the best things I've ever seen in theaters. And he instantly became my second favorite, second favorite superhero, but sort of in the movie universe, because Beast is my favorite superhero in the Marvel universe. But this was kind of like, oh shoot, I love Quicksilver. Crush on that guy right there. Loving Quicksilver. And now he's in WandaVision. And I leapt from my seat. I was Michael Jordan, 1989, the shot. That buzzer beater shot.
Seconds to go. Puts it up and scores at the buzzer. Michael Jordan has won it.
I was Brandi Chastain, World Cup penalty kick win. I was Tiger Woods that one time he was wearing that red shirt and made that putt and went nuts.
Expect anything different?
I went nuts. I was leaping out of my chair, punching the air, kicking the air, cheering. I mean, it was so exciting for so many reasons. I mean, it wasn't Ian McKellen, but this still brought back the X-Men that I love, have loved since 2000. I mean, X-Men, they are my favorite superheroes. The X-Men franchise over at Fox, sure, so many terrible movies, so many flawed movies, but it's still my favorite franchise. I just love those characters. I love what the X-Men have to say. And it means, because I did not like X-Men Apocalypse. I did not like Dark Phoenix. I haven't even seen New Mutants yet because it was so badly panned. I still plan on buying it, still gonna add it to my collection, still gonna watch it, but I haven't seen it because, you know, I was in no rush, plus the pandemic, I couldn't really go to the theater. But even if this is the only instance we get that is attached to that old franchise, I can say they went out on a high note, because I was not pleased with those last three notes, right? I can say this was their high note. Had they ended everything at Days of Future Past, they went out on a high note, but those last three films weren't for me. And I mean, I like them because they're X-Men, even though I haven't seen New Mutants. But even if this is it, if that's the only bit of the X-Men I love that shows up in the MCU, I say they went out on a high note, because WandaVision is amazing. Evan Peters is great. I mean, everything he did in Days of Future Past was off the charts, fantastic. And it's just great to see him here, right? And X-Men, again, just means so much to me. In 2000, seeing that first movie, it was mind-blowing. I mean, this was a cartoon show, the animated series from the 90s that I just loved watching as a kid so much. And then I saw it on the big screen. So this franchise just means so much to me. And then to see it sort of fizzle away with poor films that I just didn't care for so much, you know, I'll bat for though, you know, you know, I'm still cool with the franchise, you know, it's still my favorite franchise, but to see this pop up in the MCU, to see that they are going to, you know, continue with some of these characters so that that franchise is not dead and can keep going on a high note, I am just thrilled with that. I am so happy with that. And I love the X-Men, and I'm glad that it is continuing the franchise that I loved since 2000, you know, that movie franchise, watching that continue through WandaVision, maybe some movies. I mean, I remember Hugh Jackman said the only way he would come back to the role is if he was brought into the MCU in some way. And you know what? We might see that happen. And I think that is fantastic. And I'm just excited because I love all the actors that have portrayed these characters, most of them anyway. I can't think of any off the top of my head that I don't like, but I mean, Kelsey Grammer, if he could come back as Beast, I mean, that was a dream come true. Again, X-Men 3, I loved it when I first saw it, but when I bought it on DVD and started watching it, you know, I was like, you know, this isn't as good as the theater experience was, but still, Kelsey Grammer, I mean, was amazing. And if we could get him back, I mean, that would be just so good. But all I'm saying is WandaVision is so good, so risky, so brave. We're seeing so much that you don't really expect out of Disney, right? Because they play it safe, they play it normal, but this is like saccharine, maybe not saccharine, like it's like safe David Lynch, you know, in a way. I mean, it's probably not, I mean, if you know David Lynch really well, if you're really into his stuff, which I'm not, I know what I'm saying sounds dumb and stupid, but from a layman like myself with David Lynch, this is like a diet version, right? And that is a lot coming from Disney. So I am very excited. I love this and I can't get enough. My X-Men, they're still alive. They're still out there. New Mutants isn't the end. Dark Phoenix isn't the end, you know, though it's continuing. And even if that's the end, even if what we saw on this episode is the end, I'm cool with that because we went out on a high note. And to all the X-Men franchise lovers out there, everybody who loves those movies, even with the flaws, the terrible flaws. I mean, they put out some bad movies. Even with those flaws, I think we can be happy here. So I don't know. It means a lot to me. One major regret that I have is not filming myself watching that episode so you could have seen me just going wild. Like, my wife, she said, I have not seen you react to anything like that before. Like, I was all over bouncing everywhere, off the walls, off the couch. I was like Jim Carrey in The Mask when he is hopping all over the place avoiding bullets. It was just, it was so cool. I wish I had the camera on me. I didn't. Can't go back. I can only, you know, sort of express it to you in this way. But I don't know. Like, maybe the closest thing that I've ever come close to when it comes to, you know, being this excited about something is when Moonlight beat La La Land. When I saw that guy come up on stage and he's like whispering to people with a worried look on his face. I was like, wait, everybody, because we always throw Oscar parties, right? I was like, everybody, something's happening here. Something's happening. And they're like, what? I was like, I don't know, but this isn't normal. This doesn't happen. Look at his face. And then it was announced that Moonlight had won. The entire party erupted, right? Like, that was like the closest thing I think of in terms of like a television reaction for me. I think a lot of people, you know, react to sports and stuff. I'm not that big of a sports guy. I've gotten excited during sports games, but I don't know. Moonlight winning and this are the things that pushed me out of my chair, hopping around the room, super excited. And I don't know. I am elated. I think it's going to be difficult for me to fall asleep tonight because I'm going to be thinking about that episode. Before I go, I want to ask, what did you think of the episode? Do you love the X-Men franchise? And are you happy that it's being folded into this, the MCU? Or do you wish they'd go a completely different route? I mean, we still don't know what's going to happen. This could be it. There could be sprinkles. We may not get everybody from the Fox side over, but who knows? We could. Do you like this folding in? Or no? What'd you think of this episode? Anyway, let me know in the comments. Curious. And perhaps I'll see you tomorrow for more Pure Hangout.
Show me that smile again.